Hi, and welcome to the wonderful world of multimedia computing. I'm Fred Leiberger, your presenter for this session. I'm the Eastern U.S. Multimedia Support Representative for Commodore Business Machines. During this presentation, you'll see, hear, and experience the advantages multimedia have over traditional text-based information delivery systems. You'll find out what the computer requirements are for interactive multimedia. You'll see how easy and affordable it can be to develop interactive multimedia applications using the Amiga, and you'll find out why the Amiga from Commodore is the best microcomputer for multimedia. Almost all of the graphics, animations, and sounds that you'll see and hear during this presentation were created on an Amiga and will be played back from the Amiga 3000 here. The video that you'll be seeing will be coming from the laser disc under the control of the Amiga. To start, though, let me introduce you briefly to Commodore Business Machines. Commodore International Limited is, and through its subsidiaries, is one of the world's leading personal computer manufacturers with products in both the professional and the consumer channel. With over $1 billion in worldwide revenue and more than 3,000 employees, Commodore is recognized as a name brand in many countries. Products are sold in 43 countries. Approximately 1,000 dealers now distribute the Amiga in the United States. Over the past 6 years, Commodore has been second only to IBM in the total cumulative number of microcomputers shipped. The company is fully integrated with a semiconductor foundry in the United States and manufacturing facilities in Hong Kong, the U.S., and Germany. U.S. operations are headquartered in Westchester, Pennsylvania, with regional sales offices in Reston, Virginia, and San Diego, California. Commodore has a long history of providing innovative products for consumers and professionals. In 1985, Commodore introduced a breakthrough technology, the Amiga 1000, based on a special proprietary three-chip set. The Amiga was the first multitasking, multimedia personal computer with a mouse-driven color graphical interface. Business Week called the Amiga 1000 the Porsche of personal computers. The Amiga's 1000's capability still set the Amigas today apart from other computers. 4,096 simultaneously displayable colors, hardware-based graphics, real-time animation, true multitasking, four-voice, two-channel audio, a mouse-driven color graphical user interface, and much more. Since 1985, the Amiga product line has been expanded to include the Amiga 500, the Amiga 2000, and the Amiga 3000 series of multimedia computers. The CDTV player was introduced in 1990 and is the perfect low-cost multimedia delivery platform. Breaking the $1,000 price barrier, this fully Amiga-compatible multimedia player makes interactive multimedia solutions truly affordable today. When Commodore first established practical multimedia computing 7 years ago, it was viewed by many as a small niche market product. Today, the market for computers used in multimedia applications is already in the billions and growing. Multimedia has become the most significant new application area for computers. Virtually every computer manufacturer has announced their intentions to attempt to provide a multimedia class computer within the next few years. What's more, sale of interactive video courseware already exceeds 500 million, and it's expected to grow to 2.5 billion annually by 1992. In the beginning, the promise of multimedia was a new capability utilizing multiple forms of media to design and develop programs that would do everything from helping to sell a product in a store, to selling a boss on a new project or idea, to educating students in exciting, stimulating ways. Multimedia has come to mean that and much, much more. But what is multimedia? Because multimedia extends basic information processing by integrating it with animation, sound, color graphics, and video, one of the biggest challenges facing computer manufacturers today is to define multimedia. At Commodore, multimedia is defined as a method of designing and integrating computer technologies on a single platform that enables the end user to input, create, manipulate, and output text, graphics, audio, and video utilizing a single user interface. That's a lot. Breaking it down, interactive multimedia requires a computer with the ability to process text, which all computers on the market do today, to be able to produce basic sounds, to be able to display graphics with a relatively high quality resolution and multiple color selection, to be able to produce and playback animations in real time, to be video compatible, that is to be able to import video signals from tape or camera, edit and merge video signals with computer generated graphics or text, and export the resulting mix to videotape. The Amiga was the first personal computer designed with multimedia in mind. Today, even the most basic Amiga computer delivers feature for feature more standard multimedia capabilities right out of the box than other manufacturers' base platforms. Right out of the box, the Amiga has several built-in features, functions, and benefits that make it the machine of choice for multimedia applications. These include a color palette of 4096 with a palette of 4096 colors to work with. The Amiga's graphics capabilities are unequaled by any other affordable personal computer. With the Amiga and a structured drawing package or a paint package, images, high quality drawings, and diagrams are made easy. Using a technique called ray tracing, the Amiga allows even the non-artist to produce stunning photographic quality pictures. With inexpensive digitizing hardware and software, the Amiga can capture images from video cameras, VCRs, desktop scanners, making a vast resource of artwork readily available. The Amiga is the most powerful desktop animation system available to the consumer today. With a huge selection of dedicated 2 and 3D modeling and animation software available, the Amiga is the personal computer of choice for both the amateur and professional animator. Both color cycling and cell or page flipping forms of animation are fully supported on the Amiga for the real-time creation and playback of animations. Also, since memory on the Amiga is made up of non-segmented RAM, the Amiga Animator has the option to create and playback animations in real time like these, saving them both the cost and time of single frame recording. On the Amiga, ray tracing can be combined with motion to achieve very stunning and realistic results as illustrated here. And again, since we can play back animations in real time, this animation is being played back from the computer. This is not video. Notice the detail depicted and how the plane's reflection is displayed on both the inner and outer circle spheres. With high-quality, four-voice, two-channel stereo sound built in, the Amiga provides the user with easy access to sound effects, music, and MIDI capabilities, as illustrated here.
The Amiga has a built-in text-to-speech converter so it can talk like this.
The powerful Amiga family of computers from Commodore utilizes the mighty Motorola 68000 series microchip.
And of course, as illustrated here, you don't have to be a great artist to be able to take advantage of multimedia. Not bad for a group of mice. The Amiga is ideally suited for video because it was originally designed to be compatible with video. Other computers require the addition of expensive and complex video peripherals to be able to work with video. The Amiga includes several specific standard features that together make it the most video compatible computer on the market. These include a scan rate of 15.75. Typical computers scan rates are often 30 to 60 kilohertz and require external scan conversion to work with video. The Amiga, on the other hand, only needs an inexpensive NTSC or PAL encoder to be able to record its output to video. Two interlaced modes are standard on all Amigas. Thus, working with video, external interlacing is not required on the Amiga as it is with other computers. The Amiga's standard output is high-quality analog RGB, not the typical computer digital signal found on other computers. It also features a composite sync and a 4:3 display aspect ratio, making it ideal, again, for working with video. True overscan is a built-in hardware Amiga feature. Overscan is not usually found on a computer or as part of its features. Overscan allows graphics to be displayed in the entire area of the computer, thus eliminating the black border frequently found around screens on other platforms. On the Amiga, overscan is supported by software and is definable in all resolutions. One of the Amiga's expansion slots is designed exclusively for video functions. It delivers the Amiga's video compatible signal directly to the video devices such as Genlocks, frames grabbers, and digital special effects cards. On the Amiga, mixing computer artwork with video is easy with a Genlock as illustrated here. The video here is coming from a laser disc. This particular case, it happens to be Pittsburgh. The graphics are coming directly from the computer, so we have the benefit of having the impact of video plus the flexibility of being able to change things easily and conveniently with the computer. We have the best of both worlds, in essence. I think most of you would agree that the video in the background adds significantly to the impact of this type of presentation. We could add sound with it, of course. The Amiga is the only computer in its class with custom chips dedicated and devoted to graphics, sounds, and other processes. This gives the Amiga user special benefits as standard features. Other computers typically have a single CPU, be it an Intel or a Motorola chip that have to do all of the work associated with the computer. So when they have to do computation-intensive things, which multimedia is, to do things such as display graphics, to be able to animate graphics, and to also choreograph graphics with digital sound as illustrated here, that CPU is burdened and we see a slowdown or a degradation in performance. The Amiga, on the other hand, has three custom processors that aid the CPU in its effort. Affectionately known as Agnes, Denise, and Paula, Agnes takes care of the graphics and animation, Paula takes care of the sound and the input-output, and Denise takes care of the video or the screen. So when we do multimedia or other computation intensive types of things such as displaying graphics, doing animations, and choreographing animations with digital sound, we see little or no degradation of performance. If you would look at a CPU monitor right now, you would virtually see that the CPU is sitting idle. The custom processors are taking care of all of this function. What makes the Amiga so great today is simple. Custom chips to make graphics, video, and animation fly, video compatibility, and a small, tight, preemptive multitasking operating system. Unlike task switchers and cooperative multitasking systems found on other popular PCs, the Amiga features a real-time, preemptive multitasking operating system. The Amiga's operating system includes an easy-to-use, mouse-driven point-and-click visual interface and a command-oriented shell interface. The new 2.0 release of Amiga DOS added AREX, an inter-process communications language, scalable outline fonts, and several other advanced features to the Amiga platform. Amiga DOS 2.0 represents a major step forward in software technology and is part of Commodore's commitment to keeping the Amiga competitive and focused on the future. In general, multitasking means that several different programs may be active and performing tasks at the same time. For multimedia type applications, multitasking means that graphics, animation, and audio may all be performed, combined, and arranged in one production, as illustrated here. Since the Amiga's introduction in 1985, Commodore and a large network of third-party developers have worked to provide Amiga users with the finest multimedia tools possible. As a result of these efforts, Amiga users now have the greatest selection of high-quality multimedia products and applications on the market today. In addition, a complete array of traditional office productivity-type applications are available. And Amiga developers continue to write and produce new applications that will further extend the Amiga's unique capabilities, particularly in the multimedia application area. A major strength of the Amiga is that the Amiga developers have agreed to a standard software file format called IFF. There are, in contrast, many different file formats on the Mac and the IBM or MS-DOS machines. What IFF means to the user is that files created with one Amiga software package can easily be imported into and manipulated by another. It's also a simple matter to convert files from other systems for use with the Amiga. In addition to having its own preemptive multitasking operating system, the Amiga affords the user access to a variety of other operating systems, to include MS-DOS by the way of a bridge board. There are slots in the Amiga for installing unique cards manufactured by Commodore. These bridge boards, in both a 286 and a 386 class card are available, are essentially computers on a card. Once installed, they provide MS-DOS compatibility right inside of the Amiga. Bridge boards can share system resources with the Amiga, such as disk drives, mouse ports, and peripherals. MS-DOS software can be run simultaneously with Amiga programs, and data can be transferred from one of the other formats. Additionally, MS-DOS compatibility slots can accommodate further expansion cards and devices. Apple Macintosh software can be run on the Amiga by the way of a third-party product called AMAX. And AT&T System 5 Elise 4 of Unix is available for use on any Amiga with an MMU or memory management unit. Emulators are also available for less widely supported operating systems such as Atari, C64, CPM, and OS 9. There are several industry standard networking options available for the Amiga. These include Novell Client, AppleTalk, TCP/IP, NFS, X-Windows, DECnet, and peer-to-peer options. Through these options, the Amiga can easily be integrated into existing networks to provide users with the Amiga's enhanced and advanced graphics and video capability. With the Amiga's open architecture and modular design, users can easily customize any Amiga system by adding expansion and peripheral devices. Standard ports allow the Amiga user to easily connect to a wide variety of devices such as printers, modems, audio digitizers, touchscreens, and video equipment. With the addition of a wide selection of specialized cards, Amiga users can easily extend the power of the Amiga to include 16.8 million color graphics, advanced video and animation capability, high definition photorealistic imaging, and picture-in-a-picture technology. All of Commodore's products are manufactured and designed and built to the highest quality standards, and to ensure maximum end-user peace of mind, Commodore offers unprecedented support and service. In the continental United States, every Amiga is backed by a 24-hour toll-free helpline and a one-year limited warranty with free pickup, delivery, and replacement of warranty repairs. In addition, nationwide on-site and extended service contract options are available. Commodore has a long history of providing high-performance technology at an affordable price. and is recognized today as the price performance leader in the multimedia marketplace. With Amiga technology, multimedia on the desktop is not only possible today, it's doable and affordable today. And the Amiga from Commodore, when you add it all up, translates to an outstanding price performance value. Now with the Amiga, everyone can have access to a super multimedia workstation that multitasks music, art, and video in one integrated system. In earlier years, if you wanted to do a multimedia application, you would need to collect together all your graphics, sounds, animation, and literally need a desk full of computers, one for each of those. The Amiga, on the other hand, wraps all of these elements together into one system that can be used for every aspect of multimedia: creation, manipulation, integration, and delivery. This presentation was produced entirely on an Amiga. Most of the graphics, animation, audio, and video used were created from scratch using an Amiga 2 or 3D modeling package, a paint package, or a video titling package. Some of the images were captured from video or scanned into the system from a flatbed scanner. Most of the sound effects were digitized. The composites, animations, and other special effects, such as the morphing transformations, were produced with animation and/or image processing software. AmigaVision was used to choreograph and integrate it all together into a single production. And AmigaVision is now being used to control the delivery of the presentation. It can be delivered on a standard Amiga system with at least 5 megs of RAM, a hard drive, and an inexpensive Genlock such as the Amiga 2300 from Commodore. The initial growth of multimedia was slowed because of the complexity of the multimedia offering tools available. Commodore has addressed this through AmigaVision, which is a powerful, easy to learn, simple to use, icon-based multimedia offering tool for the desktop.
There are more communicators than there are programmers. For the communicating majority, Commodore presents AmigaVision. AmigaVision harnesses video, graphics, sound, animation, text, music, and more for the purposes of presenting, interactive teaching, data gathering, demonstrating, marketing, training, archiving, locating, and more. AmigaVision, the single tool for important communications.
To illustrate how easy it can be to use and create a multimedia presentation, I'll now use AmigaVision to build and present the next segment of this presentation. This is AmigaVision and has been running in the background. Generally, it starts off with a blank window. To build a presentation, basically we use icons and place them on the screen. We use a flowchart metaphor so things flow from the top down. To illustrate, if I want to build a presentation that includes some graphics, I select a screen, perhaps a second screen, a sound effect, and since I have the LaserDisc present, I'll go ahead and select the LaserDisc. Once on the screen, I double click on it and give a definition. That is, I select what media I want to use. In this case, I'll go out and locate an image that has been created in a paint package. One of the benefits of AmigaVision is the fact, and the IFF standard, is that I'm not forced to use strictly the built-in editor. I can use any of the paint tools available on the platform to create images. This particular picture was created, I think, in a video titling package. Once here, it gives me some information about it, and I do use a standard hierarchical file system where I have a root directory and subdrawers, much like other platforms. I'll turn off the pointer, which is the A, since I don't need that, and go ahead and say OK. Go to the second image, a similar process. I locate the image that I want to use. I'll turn off the pointer again. Now, rather than having this image simply jump from one image to the next, I want to go ahead and include a special effect. The current version of AmigaVision includes 18 transitions with 3 different speeds, so I can do things like wipes, fades, dissolves between images. So in this case, I'll tell it to wipe down. I could preview an item as I go, but I won't in this case because it takes away from the impact of the presentation. But when I do preview, it will show me the preceding image, the transition, and the current image. So I don't have to wait till I finish to find out what things are going to look like. The sound effect is similar. I locate the sound effect that I want to use. I could use the built-in text-to-speech synthesis, but in this case I'm using a digital sound. An audio digitizer is available for the Amiga in the range of $60 to $120 that allows me to record or digitize any audio source in either mono or stereo. Again, I could preview it, but I won't in this case. Now, rather than have these simply cascade one right after the other, I want to add some interaction to this. That is, I want to control the pace of the presentation. To do that, I'm going to use the mouse this time because the mouse is handy. And I simply pick up the mouse and drop it between. And just like on a word processor where you do an insert and it opens it up, here the icon just simply opens up and drops into place. I open the icon and I'm going to use any click of the mouse, something like the 35 millimeter slides, if you will. So now I have the first image, wait for the click, the second image, and since this is a computer, I can copy things, so I'll copy that click on down. I do want this sound to play while this graphic's up, so I'll leave that there. Go to the video, and rather than having the video playing over the existing screen, I want to put up a blank screen. Again, I can just drop it into place. Turn off the pointer since I don't need that. Then go to the LaserDisc. If I don't know what I want, I can simply go out to the LaserDisc by the way of the controller and literally search through until I find what I want. I can do things like play. I can scan. I can go fast. I can go slow. Through the process, I can also literally go one step at a time. Let me move on up to work. Have something. With 54,000 frames, a lot of times LaserDisc are used simply as a visual storage device because I can't access every single frame. In this case, though, I know what I want, so I'll simply turn all this off, go back to the system and select play, go to the first parameter and select the starting frame, which is 34,600. Okay, go to the ending frame and tell it to play the 38,500. Okay, I'll turn on the video and turn on the two audio tracks. Since there are two audio tracks, frequently these are used for bilingual type of applications, so you can have two different languages and an individual can select it. After the video plays on the last frame of the video, I want to put an animation up, so I'll select the animation. Double click on it, locate the animation. This particular animation was created in the Deluxe Paint, $149 package that also includes animation capability. I don't need the pointer. I'm going to go ahead and tell it to loop indefinitely though and wait for the mouse before it starts. Again, I'll copy the mouse down, and after the mouse finishes, I want to copy the video down and turn it off where I had it turned on before. I'll now turn off the video. So I'll tell off, 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 and so everything will be turned off. I'll tell it to go to a still, since I don't need that anymore. Okay. And now to complete the presentation, I'm simply going to go back over to the main presentation and pick up the modules that I have previously created for the ending of this presentation. So I'll move those over. I can do that, create modules ahead of time, or use one module in another presentation. So in just a few minutes, I've created a multimedia presentation that includes graphics, sounds, animation, and interaction, as well as video from the LaserDisc. I would normally save that, but in this case, I won't. I'll simply tell it to present it. And this poses a question. This was a research study that actually asked 200 vice presidents what they found wrong with traditional presentations. Those were presentations that were basically text-based, using things like flip charts and overheads. I don't know what your opinion might be, but when I press the mouse button, we'll see the second the screen come down, it'll wipe down over, and then the sound effect. 43% of them said that they were boring, 40% slept. I've always been of the opinion that 60% of them were sleeping and didn't respond. An alternative to that, though, is by the way of the LaserDisc. Multimedia is essentially a tool for communications, and as you have seen and heard, Commodore is delivering on the promise of multimedia today. Commodore has become a multimedia technology leader by concentrating on a systems approach and responding to the ever-expanding needs of multimedia innovators. The Amiga offers the best price performance for multimedia computing solutions today. Since launching its Amiga technology in 1985, Commodore's installed base of Amiga multimedia computers has grown to over 3 million, and Commodore plans to continue to maintain the Amiga's leadership role as the machine of choice for multimedia type applications.
That's all, folks.
Thank you for your time and attention.